And as Randy was talking about, maybe the worst part of the morning for you is just getting the ice off your car. Opening your door will be a challenge. Meteorologist Jennifer Shack is live in the Westchester right now. And you had some good news at last check, Jennifer. Some of the stuff that you're standing on is turning into a little bit of slushy mixture.
Yeah, when we first got here, we were having struggling. You know, the parking lot was just ice covered. And it was very dangerous. At this point, I'm able to break up the ice underneath of me. A little bit slushy now. And also good news, I was checking out the trees. They're obviously encased in ice from the overnight storm, but if you shake the limbs at this point, so I carefully head that way, we are getting some dripping off the trees. So I think in some of the metros, we may see that temperature just nestling right above the freezing mark, enough to start to melt off just a little bit. Now, obviously, the cars are going to take a considerable amount of time to melt off the encased ice, and you're still going to need this morning at least 15, if not 30 minutes to get that ice off of the cars. It should be thin enough you're able to open up those doors. If it's too thick and you can't get the door pried open, you do want to kind of tap around the edges, try to loosen that ice and proceed. But as Randy noted, also good news is just mist at this point, so no steady precipitation over the last hour here for Westchester. Reporting live, Jennifer Shack, WLWT News 5.